So when I was in the sixth grade, my class teacher told my parents that I should go and study in the school of disabled. My parents were very upset at that moment because they didn't know that I was suffering from a developmental disorder called dyspraxia, and it took them over 9 years to figure that out. If you don't know, dyspraxia is a developmental disorder in which your brain and your body parts are unable to coordinate properly. So things like holding a fork to eat Maggie or walking 50 meters without falling were next to impossible for me. But I had great parents who never gave up on me. It took me 5 years of therapies to overcome all the challenges that I faced to make me what I am today, to make me stand right here in front of you. At the age of 16, I made a mobile app called My Child, which was able to do all the things that took my parents 9 years at a point of time in less than 10 seconds. 9 years in less than 10 seconds. Today, this app is used in more than 140 countries. Few months ago, we launched a content platform called We Included, which tells the world about the stories of the differently abled community, through which we are reaching right now more than 200,000 people every single month. Over the couple of hours that you have spent here, you have learned about how to create better content, how to advertise better, and how to make your brand's image better. Now, I have a wish for all of you to fulfill. We live in a country which has a huge stigma about the most important element of human health. A country which fails to recognize the importance of mental health. I would like to ask all of you a couple of questions, and please let me know if you know the answers by raising hands, just by raising hands. How many of you know what is depression? Anxiety? Dyslexia? Vertigo? Okay. Now, how many of you know what is dysgraphia? Or how many of you know what is the difference between a disorder and a disability? A few, that's good. In India, more than 70 million people right now need clinical intervention for their mental health. But only, we just have only 3,000 doctors to help them. Most of them also fail to receive the right treatment because their families are worried about what others in the society might say. As human beings, we tend to base our lives on how the society is evolving and how we are validated socially. The brands we use, the services we sign up for, and the events we attend are all a part of our social validation. And because no one ever talks about the importance of mental health, we fail to understand why it needs to be a part of our conversation. And now we all know as marketers over here, that every single piece of decision that a human being takes is based on the pieces of information that they are getting over the course of their lives. Imagine, what if a beauty product made an ad saying, your skin might not glow properly if you won't take care of your mental health. It will not only boost their customers' confidence, but also make them subconsciously aware about the importance of mental health. Like, instead of giving them body insecurities, it will give them self-awareness. Now, a lot of you might be thinking, wait. This concerns healthcare, right? So aren't just a pharmaceuticals company supposed to take care of this thing? The fact is, everyone is supposed to take care of it because each sector plays a vital role in the development of human mind and behavior. And coming back to the point of pharmaceutical companies, yes, a lot of them do make drugs about these disabilities and mental illnesses, but still, they fail to raise awareness about the illnesses those drugs solve. Right now, today, India is the most depressed country in the world. Now tell me, what are we doing about it? And how are we solving this obvious problem? I'm thankful to Deepika Padukone and AIB to actually start speaking up about it and urging all of us to raise awareness about mental health and at least start understanding about it. And unlike how all of you think, it's pretty easy to do it. We made a video about dyspraxia, the disorder which I have, on our channel, We Included. Have a look at that. This video was made during the inception of We Included, maybe during the third day of the launch of We Included. We did not spend any money on this video, and still it got shared more than 240 times globally. To give you another example of how easy it is to raise awareness about mental health, in August 2015, Sheryl Sandberg did just one post about our work on her platform, on her profile on Facebook. Just one post. And because of that, the search trends of Google of dyspraxia increased on that particular day. Imagine if one post by a person with 4 million followers can do this. If a lot of us will start doing this, the world will start getting more aware about the developmental disorders and the mental illnesses which are out there. Depression is going to increase and increase and increase globally, according to WHO. So like we raise awareness about heart health, cancer, HIV, it's time to raise more awareness about mental health. And we can do it because content today has massive power to change people's opinions and influence their lives. Every company is trying to tap into the market so that they could give their brand's message to their customers and portray themselves as their customers' best friends. My wish is for all of us to start posting content about mental health. Start posting content about something that's very close to our customers, something that they struggle with on a daily basis, and something that they experience daily. We are doing our part, but if everyone amongst us today will start posting content about mental health on their platforms and will start making their customers aware about the importance of mental health, it can make a change. Because we alone cannot help everyone, but everyone amongst us can help someone. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Let's have a louder round of cheer one more time, ladies and gentlemen, for Harsh Songra. Thank you. Thank you so much for joining us here.
If anyone has any questions, I could take them.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. The floor is open for questions. Any questions from the audience?
Anyone has any questions? Yes.
Harsh, tell me something. I mean, commendable work, your story.
Yeah.
How do you overcome, you know, daily brass tacks issues where, you know, there's so much indifference to problems children or even people face, you know, depression, as you yourself said, is a stigma.
Yeah.
So people don't even want to talk about it.
Yeah.
So, you know, what you've done is fantastic, but people encounter, you know, daily, you know, stigma, talking about it in Indian society especially is not accepted. So how do you overcome, you know, basic, you know,
so there are two ways in which challenges? There are two ways in which people try to overcome it, and my parents have actually tried both the ways. So one way is, first of all, try, if someone is stigmatized and actually commenting on you or is actually thinking about what you are suffering from, you try to educate them that, look, it's just something which is wrong with a few parts in my body. Like it happens in other diseases, you cannot see it because it's in my mind, and it could be fixed with a certain kind of medication and a certain kind of therapies which are required. The other way to solve it is that most people, 90% of the people, actually understand it if you try to educate them, if you try to talk about it, right? The 10% of the people who don't, at times it's good, and I'm sorry to say that, but at times it's good to ignore them for a while and get better and then educate them. I'm not saying that leave them uneducated. For example, when I was in school, my teachers were not educated about the problems which I had, right? And in India, we don't have any inclusion laws which says that, okay, if this child cannot write properly, give him an hour more, correct? So now, what my parents started doing is they ignored my teachers. I started working on my skills myself. Now I go back and educate my teachers in a way to show them that, okay, this is what I had and this is how I've embraced it. They make sure that the next generation which will be coming to them would not be ignored if they have some kind of problem like I had. So there are two ways. One is to fully educate them, which 90% of them will understand. If the 10% of them are not understanding it, ignore them for a while, do your work, come back to them, and then educate them.
Any further questions, ladies and gentlemen? Well then, on that note, let's have another round of applause to thank Harsh. Harsh, I'm going to request you to remain on the stage. Yeah. I'd now like to invite Arjit Ray, who's the co-founder and management partner with Paperboat Brandworks, to please come on stage and to present to you a beautiful token of gratitude from our side. Thank you once again.